Hello, I am Jacques Torres from Jacques Torres Chocolates. I want to show you with one mix a lot of different things that you can do. We can make chocolate chips cookies. We can make chocolate chips cookies with pecan. We can also make chocolate chips cookies with candy cane crunch. So that's going to give a little crunchiness to them, but also a nice mint flavor. Also, I find in my collection of mold, this beautiful mold of little houses. And I want to try to put some cookie mix, cookie dough in it and make some little house with cookies. Let's do that. So, the first things to do is to take 2 sticks of butter or 1/2 pound of butter, put that on a bowl. Then I'm going to use 2 eggs. So, 2 sticks of butter, 2 eggs. Be careful that the butter is soft enough, and this one is. And then the whole bag of cookie mix. I like to keep my butter just soft, not completely melted. That makes the dough a little bit less sticky. This is why I like to do that. By not using melted butter, the dough really stick together, but it's not too sticky to your hands. So this is the type of dough that I like to work with. Okay, so I'm going to put that on my table. So first, we're going to make the chocolate chips cookies. I like my chocolate chips cookies to be big. And the reason is I like to have different texture when I eat them. So when I make them of that size, the center is going to be very soft. Then going outside going to be a little bit crunchy, but not too much. And then the edge going to be a little bit crunchy. So you have all those different texture by making the cookies a little bit bigger, okay? Now, I'm going to put some of the dough in here. So I have some cooking spray. I'm going to spray them all, but I doubt that I make all of them. Okay, so I'm going to take some of that dough, put it inside the mold, and be careful that the dough go everywhere. So I have the foil here. And I will remove it before it's completely baked. Okay, let's do a couple because it's a tryout. I never did it before. Again, push the dough really on the side. Okay, the last thing that I want to show you is actually to add nuts to your cookies. So there is no real recipe for that. You just take a little of the pecan pieces, mix it all together, and then one more time, we're going to scoop the cookies. One thing that you can also do is before you bake the regular chocolate chips, you can add a little bit of the candy cane crush, some nice mint flavor and a little bit of the crunch on top when they bake because the sugar is going to turn into caramel. Okay, I will put that in the oven. So what I did here, I take the house mold out of the oven and I remove the foil and I'm going to cut to make them very flat on the bottom and put them back in the oven at lower temperature and let the cookie dry a little bit more. So here, I just want to just cut the excess. So this way, when we unmold them, they will be very flat on the bottom. Okay, and we're going to put that another 10 minutes at lower temperature to dry a little bit the inside. Okay. So guess what? The cookies are ready. They came out of the oven a few minutes ago. And I want to show you what they look like. So those are the chocolate chips. So they are really giant chocolate chips. What I love here is that the side is crunchy, but if you look on the middle, it's actually not too much baked. As you can see, the color change here. And the chocolate is layered inside the cookies. There is more chocolate than dough when you make those cookies. So with one mix, you can make a lot of different cookies. You can incorporate almonds, pistachio, hazelnuts, walnuts, whatever please you. Now, As I mentioned earlier, I never did this one, so I hope they're going to come out. Oh, they are coming out. Great. So you have those beautiful little cookie house here. And I'm sure that kids would love to play with it. Maybe that's something that I'm going to make in the future and offer online. Bon appétit.